Hi, Michelle. I hope you are doing well. I just read your email and I wanted to kind of first apologize. I'm so sorry that you and Anthony are having a difficult time at home with this activity. Just know that I am doing my absolute best. I'm giving it everything I can to make sure that I'm helping my students out as much as I can when they are at home. So I apologize if you're getting lost, and I do want to kind of point out a few locations that Anthony can look if he's getting stuck or confused or anything. At the top of my Schoology page, I do have some helpful videos right in here. And so if Anthony clicks on this folder right here, he has all kinds of resources and videos that can help you understand anything that you are getting lost on. And so also, if he's not quite sure where any of his missing assignments are, if we're going back, give me a second for let it to load. Okay. At the very bottom, he should only see one folder. The rest of them are for me only. They're not in view, but he should only see that unit four folder, and again, they go in order. So we're in linear equations, and so this is the folder he's on. And you can kind of scroll down. We're doing the Monday's November 30th activity. And so I also highly, highly, highly recommend you watch the videos that I post inside of my instructions. This will give you a better idea on how to solve them. And then it also explains the activity as well. So please watch these videos. This is the best way for students to get a better understanding of their activities and their lessons. So go ahead and do that. One thing I will mention is that the number problem is what you're coloring. So our answer to this is -6. So -6, we're coloring all ones because we're in problem one, light green. So come down here. This will be light green. This will be light green. This right here will be light green. Okay. So I'm hoping that helps with that confusing. That confusion. 13. So let me go ahead and do 13 for you. So we have -98 equals -2p minus 7 times p plus 5. So what we do is that we always do the distributive property first. That's always our first step. And something I want to mention is that that negative sign in front of your numbers always stay with them. So we are going to grab negative 7 and distribute it in and multiply it to both pieces. So we're going to do negative 7 times p and negative 7 times 5. And something I always try to tell my students is that make sure you drop down everything you haven't touched. So we haven't touched the negative 98, we haven't touched the equal sign, and we haven't touched this negative 2p. So we will be left with negative 98 equals negative 2p. Oops. And then we also just solved this. So negative 7 times p is going to be negative 7p or negative 7p. Negative 7 times 5 is going to be negative 35. And so now we're here. Okay. That's step one. Step two, if you can kind of scroll up, step two is we're going to combine like terms. And I personally love, and I try to tell my students to do this as well, but I love highlighting my like terms. So numbers are like terms. So negative 98 and negative 35 are like terms. And we also have our variables, our coefficients here. So negative 2p are like terms and negative 7p are like terms. Okay, so from here, you can kind of choose what you want to combine first. I will go ahead and combine my p's first. And so what that means is we're going to drop down this negative 98 because we're not going to touch it. We're going to drop down this equal sign, and we are going to drop down this negative 35. So we are at negative 98 equals, and then we're going to combine our p's. So negative p minus 7p is going to leave us with a negative 9p minus 35 because we haven't touched that yet. But we still have like terms, right? If we go back and highlight what we still have to combine, we still have our negative 98 and we still have our negative 35. And so we do this by bringing it across our wall. So if Anthony remembers, we have this wall, our equal sign is our wall. And whenever you bring things across that equal sign, you always do the opposite operation. So if we have a negative 35, we are going to add 35 on both sides because we're doing the opposite inverse. We're slowly taking the things away by doing the inverse operation. Okay. I know that can kind of get confusing for students, but that is all we are doing for that. And so we will be left with On this left side, we are going to have negative 63 equals negative 9p. So this is where we're at now. And once you kind of, here, I'll bring it over here for you. Once you kind of realize that our like terms are combined, right? We don't have any more like terms. Negative 9p is not the same as a number. And so once we have our like terms combined, we are going to actually divide everything to get p on its own. And we are going to divide by negative 9. And dividing by negative 9 is going to get p isolated, because negative 9p divided by negative 9 will eliminate each other. And so you'll be left with p equals, and then negative 63 divided by negative 9 will leave us with a positive 7. So p equals 7. So we're going to color all 13s, because that's the problem we're in, negative or positive 7. So 7 will be dark green. This will be dark green. This will be dark green. Okay. And then we also said we're struggling with 15. So let me go ahead and do 15 for you. Yes, this one is a difficult problem. And so looking at this, our very first step is to do the distributive property. However, so we're going to go ahead and distribute this 5. That's always our first step to get rid of those parentheses, distributive property. So we're going to grab this 5 and multiply it to both pieces. 5 times x over 5 and 5 times negative 3. And so we will be left with 30 equals 5x over 5 minus 15. So the awesome thing about this is that because we have a 5x over 5, our 5s are actually going to eliminate each other, because 5x over 5, those 5s will disappear. And so we are going to be at 30 equals x minus 15. And the awesome thing here is that we only have one step after that, because we had to combine our like terms, and 30, so let's highlight those. 30 and negative 5 are in fact like terms. So we are going to add 5, 15 on both sides, because we're going across that wall. So you have to do the inverse operation, and you'll be left with 45 equals x. So everywhere you see a 15, you're going to color red, because our answer is 45. So this will be red. Where else will be red? I'm not seeing any other 15s. But I'm hoping this was helpful. If you have any questions or anything, you have your steps here that you can kind of look at as well. Please let me know, and I hope this was helpful. All right, have a great day.